New CNN polling out tonight shows almost two-thirds of Americans say they believe the women alleging affairs with Donald Trump before he became president. 21% say they believe the president's denials of those affairs. Last night, CNN's Randi Kaye spent the evening with a group of women, all Trump supporters, who watched my interview with Stormy Daniels.
You're smart. She's enjoying this way too much.
On Palm Sunday, these conservative Christian women gathered in Dallas to watch Stormy Daniels' interview on 60 Minutes.
She was shopping her story for money. Exactly. Just like all the other people that have tried to make money off the Trump name.
What was your first impression of Stormy Daniels?
I feel sorry for her. My heart hurts for her.
This is a porn star. Why are we giving it any credibility?
Exactly.
And the fact that she now wants to come out with a story because she's afraid of her children? My goodness, would you tell the kiddos about your full-time job?
These women all voted for Donald Trump. And despite Stormy Daniels' claims, they still don't buy her story.
Why would she come out and give this interview if she
more
wasn't
money.
Telling the truth? Based on this interview, do any of you believe that Stormy Daniels did have sex with Donald Trump?
I don't believe it because I haven't seen any hard proof.
Then
should
we
believe the president of the United States
or
a stripper porn star? I go with the president of the United States.
Yeah. Yes.
Most in this group believe God ordained Donald Trump to be president and stand by him despite his imperfections.
I know that when I voted for him, I wasn't voting for a choir boy.
He had to change as a person in order to become a president. Stormy Daniels, if you, the lifestyle that she's leading right now, I mean, I wish she would turn her life over the way that Trump has.
Amen.
This group suggests the women coming forward with tales of having had an affair with Trump are being targeted.
Someone is looking and shopping for these people to come out of the woodwork because it is demeaning to our president.
And as some strongly suggested, all part of a media plot to bring down Donald Trump.
You can throw all of that stuff up in our face as many times as you want, but that means that we will work harder for Trump. Is that not so, lady?
That's correct. This is the media defining the narrative. The people, we the people, are ready to define the narrative. And it's not about tawdry sexual peccadillos.
In order for somebody to come forward, you can be pushed by somebody else.
Correct.
Right? And so I think the thing is you're looking for a way to impeach my president that I worked very hard for.
I'm asking you about a Stormy Daniels interview on 60 Minutes, period. That's it.
And about that so-called hush money, these women don't see Trump's fingerprints on it, only his lawyer, Michael Cohen's.
Maybe he thought he was just doing a favor to try to quash some negativity.
Mm-hmm. Right when they were starting
the campaign. Even though it didn't even happen, just to get rid of the story that's not even true.
Which would also follow suit that non-disclosure was unsigned because Trump may not have known about it at all.
Worst case scenario, if he slept with her, whatever. That's between him, the Lord, and his family.
Exactly.
That is not about the job he's doing in running our country, which he's doing an amazing job.
Randi Kaye, CNN, Dallas.